Welcome to this video in the series on limits. So we've already been studying limits, and the topic of this video are limits where we have somehow to do with infinity. It can be that we take the limit for x going to plus infinity or x going to minus infinity, or maybe we have that x goes to some fixed value, just a number, and that the function that we are trying to take the limit of goes to plus or minus infinity. And this will also lead naturally to asymptotes of a function, so either horizontal or vertical asymptotes. So let's have a quick look at what we will cover in this video. So limits with infinity, that's the topic. And then when you are talking about limits with infinity, of special interest are those where we have a fraction. So for instance, rational functions, polynomial over polynomial. And for those types of limits, It is basically, if x is going to infinity, it's a kind of race. Who is going to infinity fastest? If it is the numerator, then the whole thing will go to infinity. If it is the denominator that goes to infinity fastest, then the whole thing will go to zero. And they can also balance out so that we get a number there. And then I will also show you a little bit on finding asymptotes. And that is, of course, a way to sketch a function. Now, before I go to some new theorems, let me go back to something that we have already seen. So a little example, we already studied before the function fx is 1 over x. And if you sketch that, you know that it looks approximately like this. It's a hyperbola. And one branch of that hyperbola looks like this. So what you see here is that if we let x go to infinity, that the function goes to zero. And if we let x go to zero from above, then the function goes to plus infinity. And then it has another branch for negative x. So it's defined for all x except for x equals zero. Then we have division by zero. And what you see here, if x is going to minus infinity, it goes to zero. And if x is going to zero from below, then it goes to minus infinity. So let's write that down, what we immediately see in the graph here. So we have that the limit x is going to plus infinity, 1 over x equals zero. We have something similar for x going to minus infinity. If x goes to zero from above, so that means that we take very small positive x values, say 1/1000, then 1 over x becomes plus 1000, so this will go to infinity. And finally, we have that the limit x comes from below to zero, so small negative numbers, 1 over x equals minus infinity. So I wrote down these numbers here, and you may think that this means that the limit exists, but we say that the limit does not exist. So writing down this plus infinity and minus infinity gives a little bit of extra information, but the limit does not exist. So for a limit to exist, you really want it to go to a number like 10, a half, pi, square root of 2, whatever, but not plus or minus infinity. Also, let's see the statements that it goes to 0 means that we have horizontal asymptotes here. So let me also write that down. So these means that the function has a horizontal asymptote, both for x going to plus and minus infinity. So the function creeps towards the line y equals zero. And these two statements here means that there is a vertical asymptote. X equals zero. So just a bit of information that we have here. Now let's try and make it a little bit more complicated. So another example. And now I'm going to consider the function fx equals x plus 1 over x minus 3 and x plus 2. So you see that the domain of f is, well, every real number as long as we delete minus 2 and 3. Because for those x values, we have division by 0, and that is undefined. Now, suppose that we would like to know the limit for x going to minus 2 of x plus 1 over x minus 3 times x plus 2. Well, what you can see, what you probably see is if I just plug it in, which is always what you should try first for a limit, here we have minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Here, minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5. And here, well, this is going to become 0, right? X plus 2. But whether it is, if we take the limit, that means that we are going to take x values close to minus 2, but not equal to minus 2. Then if we take values that are slightly to the right of minus 2, say minus 1.9, then this is going to be a positive number. And for those types of values, what we would have is that we get a negative number, and this thing is going to be positive. So the whole thing will go to plus infinity. If we take the limit of x going to minus 2 and we go from the left, from below, so for instance we take minus 2.1, then we have a minus sign here. This is also negative, and then this will also be negative. So what we will have then is minus, 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 and altogether the thing will go to minus infinity. So to determine what the function does, whether it goes to plus infinity or minus infinity, you have to look at the sign of the individual terms here. So let's try to write that down a bit more mathematically. Well, first, let's try to write this down in words. So for values of x close to minus 2, comma, we have x plus 1 is negative, x minus 3 is negative, and the sign of x plus 2 depends whether x is less than minus 2 or x bigger minus 2. And if you would write this down in limits, it means that the limit x is going to minus 2 from above, so from the right, minus 1.9, x plus 1, x minus 3, x plus 2. So what we get, let me in red indicate the sign here. So this is negative, this is negative. And if we take, say, minus 1.9 plus 2, it's going to be positive. So the whole thing, minus over minus becomes plus. So the whole thing goes to plus infinity. And the limit x coming from below x plus 1, x minus 3, x plus 2. So what we then have for the sign is this is still negative, this is also negative, but now this one is also negative. So the whole thing is going to minus infinity. Just to recall, we covered that in a previous video. I could also write for the first limit, I could also write the limit x going to minus 2 with a little plus. And here I could also write a limit x is going to minus 2 with little minus sign. So this notation from above, from the right, that is the same as this one. And this notation from below or from the left, so values to the left of minus 2, you can also write it as minus 2 with a superscript of minus. Okay, so the limit does not exist because it goes to plus or minus infinity, but we have some additional information, and if you would like to sketch the graph, then you can use that. That if you come from the right here and you would sketch the graph, then you would know that it does something like this. If you approach here, minus that is not minus 2, but you know what I mean. It goes above when you come from the right, and it goes to minus infinity when you come from the left towards minus 2, and it can help you sketch the graph. Okie doke. So a bit more general. You can use this statement if you have to compute limits of 1 over x to the power alpha. So we have already seen in the first example 1 over x, and it holds a little bit more general. So you can write there an alpha, and as long as alpha is a positive number, then this will still go to 0 for x going to infinity. And what you can also use is if you have a polynomial, so here is a polynomial of degree n, and if your function goes to plus infinity, then the limit of the polynomial only depends on this term. So that is the term that has highest power of x, the leading term it's sometimes called. And if the coefficient of this number is positive, then the whole thing will go to plus infinity, and if the coefficient is negative, then it will go to minus infinity. So for a polynomial, only the highest power is important, and the rest is much smaller compared to this highest order term. So the highest order term depends whether the whole function goes to plus infinity or minus infinity, depending on the number that is in front of it, the coefficient. Now, as I said, with rational functions, you get to interesting situations. So here is a limit, and if you take x going to plus infinity, you see that the numerator, 2x squared minus 3, that will go to plus infinity, since 2x squared determines that, and 2 is a positive number. The denominator, only the 7x squared is important, and 7 is a positive number, so this will also go to plus infinity. So what the whole thing does is not immediately clear. Now, the standard trick to do these types of limits is that you're going to look only at the denominator at first. What you're going to do is you're going to pick the highest power of x. So for this polynomial, that's 7x squared. And now we're going to divide every single term in this limit. So this term, this term, this term, this term, and this term, all 5 of them. We are going to divide them by x squared. So let's do that. So the standard method is divide all terms by the highest power of x in the denominator, and that's 2 here. So here is our limit. I divide every single of these 5 terms by x squared. Then you can simplify it, and you see that we are being left with this. That's just simplification. And now you see why I do this, because now I can take the limit using the standard limit that I know that 1 over x to the power alpha goes to 0 for x going to infinity if alpha is a positive number. I can use that here. And then I see that this one will disappear, and this one will go to 0, and this one will go to 0. And we are left with 2 over 7. So what you see here is we have a numerator that goes to infinity. If you just look at this polynomial, it will go to infinity. We have a denominator that also goes to infinity, and apparently they balance out. So together they go to 2 over 7. Now, if you would have a higher power of x here, if this would be an x to the power 3, then you can probably imagine that the whole thing will go to 0. Then the denominator wins. If we would look at this question and we would change this x squared to an x to the power 3, you would see that the numerator still goes to infinity after dividing by the x squared, and the whole function here, this whole thing, goes to infinity. So several things can happen, and here are some test questions that you should try and solve on your own. So you have this limit, and the way to tackle it is the standard trick. You look at the denominator, take the highest power of x, and then you divide all five terms by the highest power of x. Same for this question, and you will find a different answer, and for this question. So that is the standard trick. It will always work for these types of questions where x is going to infinity. So try to solve them, and if you manage to do so, you can pause the video and then look. Then you can find answers here. So don't look at them immediately. First try to solve them, but then you can check whether you were on the right track. If you have any questions, just let me know. So finally, let's look at this example here. So say that we have given this formula here. F of x is x squared over 4 minus x squared. And we are being asked to find all the asymptotes, the horizontal and the vertical ones. So for horizontal asymptotes, you have to compute the limits for x going to plus infinity and x going to minus infinity. And they will tell you whether there is an asymptote or not. For vertical asymptotes, you have to look where the function is undefined, so where the denominator, 4 minus x squared, becomes 0. So let's go ahead and do that. So in addition, for if you have vertical asymptotes, so they will occur when this is 0, so for x equals 2 and x equals minus 2, you also have to check how you approach these difficult points from the right or from the left. Because it can be that your function does something like this. So it can happen that on different sides of the difficult point, the function either goes to plus or minus infinity. So all three situations, and finally this one, can happen. So the function can go to plus or minus infinity from the left, and it can go to plus and minus infinity from the right. So let's see what happens here. Here I plotted the graph, but normally you do it the other way around. But this is just for you to understand what we will find. So what we are going to find by computing these asymptotes, by computing these limits and finding the asymptotes, is that we have one for x going to plus infinity. We have the same horizontal asymptote for x going to minus infinity. And then we have two vertical asymptotes, x equals minus 2, x equals plus 2, and the function behaves like this. So indeed, on different sides of minus 2, it goes to plus and minus infinity. But we'll find that using limits. So first of all, we take the limit for x going to plus infinity. So we have this function. We look at the denominator. The denominator is 4 minus x squared. Highest power of x is 2, so we divide everything by x squared. In the numerator, we find a 1. Here we find 4 of x squared, and here we find minus 1. So now we can take the limit. We let x go to plus infinity. This thing goes to 0, and we are left with minus 1. For x going to minus infinity, we can do something similar. So we also divide by x squared, and we find the same limits, also minus 1. So the conclusion is we have a horizontal asymptote, y equals minus 1, for x going to plus or minus infinity. So next, let's consider vertical asymptotes. So the denominator, 4 minus x squared, is 0 for minus 2 and plus 2. So the function does not exist at those points, and they are candidate points for asymptotes. If you compute the limit x going to minus 2 from the left, so here I use the other notation, then we have this function here. And the reason is, so limit x goes from below to minus 2, I use both notations, x squared 4 minus x squared, or if you like, the limit x is going from below to minus 2 x squared 2 plus x to minus x. So what you see, this is an x squared, that's always positive. We come from the left to minus 2, so x is minus 2.1, say. So then we have 2 minus 2.1. So this thing is going to be negative. And we have 2 minus minus 2.1. This is going to be positive. So what we have is that the whole thing goes to minus infinity, as it says here. But this is with the intermediate steps. And we have three more of those limits, right? So there is also the limit going to minus 2 from the right. And then we have to consider x equals 2. And then we also have a limit from the left and a limit from the right. What you see here also, this result, is basically that the function goes here to minus infinity. So when we approach x equals minus 2 from the left, we see that the function goes to minus infinity. So that's what it says here in the picture. If we do the other limit, so we go to minus 2 and then from the plus side, we find plus infinity. And we can also do the limit of going to 2 from the left, and you would find plus infinity. You can check that. And if we go to 2 from the right, then we find minus infinity. So the last one, it means that we go to, here is x equals 2, so we approach a value like this, and you see that you go to minus infinity. So what we have found is that this function will have vertical asymptotes at minus 2 and at x equals 2. That wraps it up for this video. So let's see what we studied. We have considered limits where x is going to plus or minus infinity. We have looked at limits with rational functions. So the standard trick is to divide by the highest power of x in the denominator. And then we considered how to find the horizontal and vertical asymptotes of a function. That wraps it up, and I'll see you in the next video.